Hi guys, welcome back to VFX rendering. In the last video, we compared Redshift render farms. After Redshift, the next render engine should be OctaneRender. Octane is an unbiased GPU render engine with real-time capability. It is popular and powerful. But unlike Redshift, Octane is not supported widely across render farms. So let's find out whether our 5 best render farms support Octane or not and how fast they render our project. Today, we will run a small Octane test on various render farms. The project consists of 21 frames in 1920x1080 pixel resolution. The file size is around 700 megabytes. The software we use is Cinema 4DR26 and Octane 2022.1. As usual, we will test it on 5 render farms: Fox Render Farm, Garage Farm, iRender Farm, Ranch Computing, and RebusFarm. However, Fox Render Farm and Garage Farm do not support Octane Render. So there will be only 3 render farms in this video: iRender Farm, Ranch Computing, and RebusFarm. The first render farm is iRender Farm. iRender provides powerful remote desktops. Users will access their machines remotely and render on them. First, we will transfer the project through their application called iRender Drive. It is really fast, about 30 seconds of uploading. Next, you need to create an instance to work on. We use one node of the 2GPU 4090 package. Now fire the instance up. Once you are on the server, render the scenes as if it was your own computer. As you can see, the project renders in 10 minutes and 51 seconds. The render cost is $2.70. Until now, we only use one instance for rendering at iRender Farm. So we have an idea to divide the project and render a different range of frames on each instance. Okay, we will test this idea on 3 instances of the 8GPU 3090 packages. Each instance renders 7 frames in 2 minutes and 20 seconds. So when we render the frames on each instance at the same time, the render cost in total is about $3.30, while the render time is only about 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Note that the time and expense don't include installation time. I think the divide frame thing is very useful for big projects. The render time is cut down many times while the cost is still the same. But it takes time to set up the instance. If you hesitate to do so, one node of the 4090 packages is already enough. Next is Ranch Computing. You will need to install their plugin called Ranch Checker. It will be integrated into your 3D software package, which is C4D. This plugin gathers all the assets used by your scene, verifies the rendering parameters, and warns you in case of possible issues. After creating the archive, you can upload it directly from the application via iNCHSYNC. The other way is what we are doing right now. Simply drag and drop your file prepared by the Ranch Checker in the white zone to start the upload. You can check the progress of the upload and render in the web manager. Ranch upload is fast, more than 2 minutes. Now it's their job to render for you and notify you when it's done. It takes Ranch 4 minutes and 36 seconds to complete the render. It costs 16.38 render points or €16.38. The last render farm is RebusFarm. You will need to install their software called RebusDrop. The plugin will integrate into your Cinema 4D and let you send the project to the farm directly from your application. Go to the RebusFarm setup window, configure the settings, and upload. The RebusDrop will upload your rendered job, including all the assets needed for rendering. Then you can check the progress of the upload in Render in the control center. Uploading to RebusFarm is kinda slow, more than 1 hour. After uploading successfully, let's render. For a small number of frames, the render farm assigns a few nodes to render. As you can see, Rebus assigns 7 nodes for our scenes. So, unless you are in the queue for too long, it's unnecessary to choose a higher priority. Rebus renders our scenes in 12.30 minutes and charges 8.78 render points, or €8.78. Unfortunately, the result is not as we expected. It seems that an asset is missing, and the RebusDrop plugin couldn't check this issue before uploading. So, we have tested the 21-frame project with C4D Octane on 5 render farms. Here are the results. Fox Render Farm, not support Octane. Garage Farm, not support Octane. iRender Farm, total cost, $2.70, render time, 10 minutes and 51 seconds. Ranch Computing, total cost, €16.38 or $17.50, render time, 4 minutes and 36 seconds. Rebus Farm, total cost, €8.78 or $9.40, render time, 12 minutes and 18 seconds. iRender can be faster if you set up more nodes to render at the same time. In this video, we also test rendering on 3 nodes of the 8GPU 3090 package at once, and the result is about $3.30 for render cost, and 2 minutes 20 seconds for render time. From the results above, Fox Render Farm and Garage Farm don't support Octane. Of the 3 remaining render farms, Ranch Computing is the fastest, while iRender Farm is the cheapest render farm. That's all about today. What is your experience with C4D Octane Render Farm? We will continue making more render farm comparison videos. If you want us to make a video for any software, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and like if you like our videos. See you next time.